for staying with us. Now, the Great African Seaforest is being put under the spotlight through a new Netflix original documentary called My Octopus Teacher. It features rare and extraordinary footage of a man's unexpected bond with a curious little octopus in an effort to show the delicate ecosystem that lies beneath the waves. Premiering on the 7th of September, this project is the brainchild of Cape Town-based NGO, the Sea Change Project, that's been connecting people to nature through world-class storytelling for over a decade. And to tell us more about this, we are joined on Skype by South African natural history filmmaker, ocean storyteller, and this picture's director, Pippa Ehrlich. Pippa, a very good morning to you. Thanks for joining us. Welcome.
Good morning. Thanks very much for having me on the show.
Now, before we get into the documentary, just briefly tell us about the Sea Change Project. What is it that you do there?
So, Sea Change Project is a group of divers and filmmakers and scientists and storytellers. And we are dedicated to going into the water every day in Cape Town and exploring the Great African Seaforest. And the Great African Seaforest is this enormous underwater kelp forest that hugs our coastline all the way from Dahop in the east up the Namibian coast.
Let's now talk about the My Octopus Teacher documentary feature. What inspired it?
So the film was inspired by an experience Craig Foster, who's kind of tells the story in the documentary. So he started diving in the sea forest about 10 years ago. He was suffering from burnout and he decided he never wanted to make another film again. And in that process, the first thing that happened to him is he died without a wetsuit, and diving in the cold water really helped him to get his energy back. And then he started going down and looking around, and he noticed all of these incredible animals that lived in the kelp forest. And eventually he met this very curious little octopus, and he kind of saw her and she was curious. And then he went back the next day and she was still interested in him. And over time he won her trust. And they formed this bond, and that's what the story's about, his year in the wild and his friendship with an octopus.
Mm. And it's based beneath the waves of the Great African Sea Forest. Do take us through about the thought process around the choice of this setting.
So we didn't choose the setting. The setting kind of chose us. This is the place that we dive every day. We are fascinated by it and passionate about it. And it's this incredible underwater wilderness filled with animals that you can never imagine. And each of them has a truly fascinating life and a fascinating story. And there are many, many animals like the octopus that we could have made a film about. But the other thing that's so precious about this environment is that kelp forests are very, very important ecosystems. They provide nursery areas for fishes. They give us oxygen. They absorb carbon. And what's happening around the world is that 40% of our world's kelp forests are currently in decline. 25% of our global coastlines are covered by kelp forests. And the Great African Sea Forest is very, very special because it's a relatively healthy ecosystem. And it's something that we as South Africans should be very, very proud of. It's also a place where human beings have lived for more than 100,000 years. There's nowhere else on Earth that human beings have been based in one place for that long. It was on this coastline that the first science and the first art, well, the first evidence of science and art was discovered by archaeologists.
Okay.
So for South Africans and for people all over the world, the Great African Sea Forest is our original home. And that's really why we want to tell stories about it and inspire people to value and protect it.
And what is it really that you, James Reed, Craig Foster and the crew aimed to capture and highlight through this project?
I think we really wanted to capture the importance of having a relationship with the natural world and the incredible wonder and transformation that a human being can go through when they make that connection with nature. And we're not really talking only about, you know, wild animals underwater. You can connect anything. You can connect to a pot plant in your apartment. You can connect to a tree in the park down the road from you, or a praying mantis that walks it through your door one morning. And we need to start looking at our relationship with nature, because nature is the life support system for every single human being on Earth. And biodiversity is the immune system of planet Earth. So if we don't start treating it as if we are part of it, we're already in big trouble in terms of what's happening to our global environments.
Yeah, and we are in trouble as well, because I understand that about 40% of the world's kelp forests have shown declined, and some have completely disappeared. What caused this, and what can be done to protect them from extinction?
I don't think they're facing extinction just yet, but certainly in some areas they have gone extinct. And the biggest problem is climate change. In places like Tasmania, a warm current shifted its course. And as that warm current moved, a whole lot of urchins that didn't normally live in that area moved in, and they just devoured the entire kelp forest. And similar things have happened on the coast of California. Similar things have happened in southern Australia and in Japan. But that's why we're so lucky, because our kelp forest, you know, that habitat is intact. And if we protect it, it'll be there forever. And that's what we want, is for our children and our children's children to still be able to not just experience this wonderful place, but be able to gain benefits from it.
Yeah. I would imagine making such a film is not an easy task. Just take us through the process it took to capture this and putting it together into the My Octopus Teacher final product.
Yeah, so it was quite a process. By the time I got involved with the film, Craig had already followed this octopus throughout her entire life. So I was very lucky that I arrived with an incredible library of footage, and the story was ready to be told. But Craig wanted to make this film with no scuba diving gear and with no wetsuits, because when we go into the water, we don't wear wetsuits. So the first thing that I had to do before I could even, you know, start working on the script is I spent 6 months getting my body used to the cold water.
Wow. Yeah, and I hear that the film, Pippa, has been captivating film festivals worldwide, racking up nominations and wins. Tell us more about this exciting news.
Yeah, so we've been completely overwhelmed by the response we've got from the film. We won the EarthX Impact Film Festival a few months ago. We've got 8 Jackson Wild nominations, which is one of the biggest natural history film festivals in the world. We've got 2 at Wild Screen, which is the other big natural history film festival. And we've also just been getting the most incredible comments from people all over the world. Some of them other filmmakers who I really admire, like Louis Sohoyo, who made the Oscar-winning film The Cove. But I think the most exciting thing is to get comments like, this film inspired me to take my children out into nature, and this film made me think about the value of motherhood, and it made me think about how precious it is to have a relationship with nature. And it reminded me that we need to think very carefully of the world that we're leaving for our children. So I think that's what's exciting for us, is that people are connecting with this film in such an emotional way and really being able to relate to the deeper messages that we were trying to get across.
Okay, Pippa, great chatting to you. Thank you so much for your time. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Well, joining us on Skype there is South African natural history filmmaker and ocean storyteller Pippa Ehrlich, and we were just in conversation with her about their new documentary, My Octopus Teacher, that's premiering tomorrow on Netflix.